Hi friends, welcome back to Angular unit testing series. In this series, I'm talking about unit testing in Angular using Jasmine framework. In the last video, I have explained about how we can use spy. In this video, let's see about the use of before each execution block. Let's start. I'm going to take our previous example to explain this before each concept. Let me comment this specification and uncomment this specification so that we can easily understand the before each without confusion. I have already started the test runner using ng-test, and so we can see this is getting passed. Okay, I'm going to add a new function in this calc service to add two numbers. Now we need to write the specification for this function. Let me copy this and change accordingly. We can see this test is also getting passed. But the problem here is we are duplicating some codes. Actually, here we have only two lines of code. But sometimes we may need to duplicate lot of codes. For this kind of scenario, where we need to do something before we execute a specification, we can use before each execution block. So inside the describe function, let me add a before each block. Like this. For now, let me put a console log. Now we can see before each is executed, before each specification. So now, instead of instantiating the services in each specification, I can do it in before each. Like this. Now we can see the test specifications are passed. But now we are not duplicating any codes. But we are having another problem here. We are manually creating the instances of the services. We are not using the dependency injection. To avoid that, we can make use of the Angular TestBed utility. TestBed is used to provide the dependencies to our services by using dependency injection instead of calling constructors explicitly. Let me use the TestBed, which is present in angular/core/testing. In this TestBed, let me use the configure testing module method, which accepts one object. This is similar to our module, where we have imports array, declarations array, providers array, etc. I'm going to use the providers array to provide the services. Like this. Now I need to use the inject method from testbed to inject the service. Like this. So that we can see our test is getting passed. But this time we are not manually creating the instance of the services. Instead, we are using the dependency injection. And here you can see we are creating the actual instance of the service. Assume we are creating the spy object instead of actual service. Now we can also provide that. First, we need to use the property provide, in which we can specify the injection token name, which is going to be our service name. And then we can use the useValue property to specify the spy object. And so we can see our specifications are passed now. Okay, I hope you understood how we can use before each execution block to execute something before each test execution. And also how we can use TestBed to create the instances using dependency injection. Before we close, let me introduce another small concept. Now we can see 6 specs are getting executed from 4 test suites. Assume we have some error in home component test suite, and so we don't want to execute that now. For that, we can go to the home component spec file and change this describe to xDescribe. Now we can see this test suite is not executed. Still pending. Similarly, we can also skip a particular test spec. For that, let me open the app component spec and change this it to exit. Now we can see this test spec is also skipped. Also, for some reason, if you want to focus only on one test suite, we can use F instead of X in describe. Now we can see, except this test suite, all other suites are grayed out. Similarly, we can use F in it to focus on a specific test spec. Now we can see only this spec is executed in the test suite. That's all for today. Please like this video and support me. I'll be back with next concept soon. Thank you. Bye.